Are you already using the new Microsoft Outlook? I have a new feature for you. This is called offline mode. With this feature, you can work even if you are not connected and online. So you can draft emails, you can send emails, you can play with events in calendar, and when you are back online, everything will be sent out. So stay tuned. And let me walk you through every new feature and capability available in the offline mode in the new Outlook. Sooner or later will come and will replace the classic Outlook. Stay tuned and let's move forward. And here I am in the official Microsoft documentation about working offline on Outlook. How you can turn on this feature? By going in the general, in settings, you can find offline. You have a bunch of options like selecting the range where you want to save and drop your email on your personal storage, on your PC or laptop. Then you can decide in which folder you want to store locally all emails and content that you have in the new Outlook. So let's see now what you can do when you are offline. Currently, right now, what you can do is read, manage, and view Outlook items like read emails, create and save new emails draft, send new messages to Outlook, rename folders, view your calendar and events, view your people. You can perform actions on email like archive, categorize, delete, flag unflag, ignore, mark as read, unread, move to focus at other, move to folder, pin, wrap or junk, not junk. And finally, in the settings, what you can do is check your Outlook version, automatic replies, categories, email accounts, and people view. This is what you can do when you are offline in Outlook. Now, Microsoft is working to expand this capability with more features, and currently, you cannot create or delete or move folders, reply and forward emails. You cannot accept meeting invitations, search for items, sort and filter. So there's still a lot to do, but Microsoft is working, and probably for the end of this year, we will see more and more capabilities coming in the offline mode, which is highly required, of course. Now, let's switch on the demo environment. Here I have Outlook, the classic version of Outlook, open. Now, sooner or later, the new Outlook will take over this one. So now, if I want to switch to the new Outlook, if you don't have already, you have this toggle button, in the upper right corner that will allow you to switch to the new version of Outlook. Now, this thing is handled by your admin in your organization. So if you don't see this toggle button, you have to probably ask to your IT admins so they can provide you information why they don't have released this function in the company. Now, let's see immediately how you can turn on this functionality. By going in general, you can find offline. So let's click here, and now what I can see is that offline mode is already turned on for email, calendar, and people. So this is my demo email for my Microsoft 365 tenant, and here you have to select where you want to store your content. Choose which folder will be used to save a local copy of your content of Outlook. And then, very important, is selecting the range, 7 days, 30 days, 90 days, let's say 90 days. All right, let's hit the button save, and now, theoretically, I'm ready to go. It's time to turn off the Wi-Fi, so I'm going to close the Wi-Fi. I am offline now. Now that I am offline, let's create an email for my colleague Patty Fernandez. So let's type something, test offline mode, the same thing in the subject, and now this email will be saved in draft. Once I am back online, this email will be sent. Now, for the moment, considering that I am offline, this email will be dropped in the outbox. So let me open now outbox, and as you can see, I have the email that I just sent to Patty Fernandez. Let me turn on the Wi-Fi. Now I am connected and the email is gone, is sent to Patty Fernandez. Last thing that I would like to call out here is when you are offline, let me go offline again, you can jump on calendar, for example, because this is allowed. But as we read the documentation, you can see to do, for example. This is not allowed when you are offline, or still not allowed. The same thing for OneDrive, or if you use the admin app. So there are a bunch of limitations, as we have seen. So you may experience a warning message that tell you that this is not possible. But for other things, email, events, this is still possible. All right, we have seen how it works, the offline mode in the new Outlook. If you enjoyed this video, please consider to subscribe, like, add a comment down below. Let me know what do you think about this new capability. I hope to see you next time.